Everybody, been a while, but I'm back with a new tutorial on the triple caw. Triple caw? What? Can't you just do a tech and two caws or tech or something like that? Why do I need to learn this? Well, you don't really. You can actually get by fine with either of those techniques. In fact, those are what I play most of the time, but I also like to have this triple caw technique in my toolbox to pull out every once in a while. I'm going to have a play-along practice section toward the end of the video, but first let me just give you a few reasons why I think the triple caw is a useful thing to know. What I like to do a lot of the time is hold down a basic beat with my right hand and do all the embellishment with my left hand. So my right hand is just doing dooms and slaps, and the left fills in the rest. That way my right hand doesn't lose track of what it's doing to have to go do an extra tech. Another cool thing about the triple caw is that sometimes when you're improvising, your right hand can end up in a place where it's at the end of the beat and it's doing a tech, and it's hard to get down there for the doom on the one. But if you're using the triple caw, then your left hand is going to be doing the last caw, and then your right hand is just ready to go on the doom. The triple caw is also the gateway to the infinite caw. You start out learning the caw, then you build up to the double caw, then the triple, and at that point you can pretty much, and that becomes particularly useful when you want to do something like pitch changing pops. Like another cool thing about it is just that having different ways to play the same things, that means your body is moving differently, and that means you're going to be thinking about the beat a little bit differently, and that can lead to ideas, beats, fills, solos that you wouldn't have come up with otherwise. So there are other ways of playing the beats I'm going to be showing you in this video. And those other ways might even be easier for you, at least at the get-go. Like anything else new, it's going to take quite a bit of repetition to get the muscle memory down to really feel it if you haven't done this much before. Hopefully you already know the double caw and the slap. If you don't have those down yet, you're going to have a bad time. If you do, bear with me and let's see where this goes. And as always, remember to relax and breathe. This is the simplest exercise possible for developing the triple caw. It's just three caws in a row. And you're going pointer, ring, pointer. Pointer, ring, pointer. The pause at the end of the third one allows you to reset, because it's essentially two pointer caws in a row. Here's a saidi with a triple caw on the end. Let's see what happens when we fill in that saidi a little bit more. Here's an ayub. It's three measures of a simple ayub and then a triple caw on the fourth. Here's a beat I often use when I'm playing along with reggae music. Here's a beat that I learned from a Gucci Mane song. have a little fun with that.